Israel's Ministry of Defense announced that it successfully intercepted multiple drones during a test of an airborne high-power laser weapon. The demonstrated system is being hailed as a strategic change in the air defense capabilities of the State of Israel. The system is likely to be integrated into Israel's multi-layered integrated air defense system. The demonstration was carried out by the Israeli Air Force's IAF Yanat Missile Test Unit. Israel's Directorate of Defense Research and Development DDR&D and Israeli defense contractor Elbit Systems. As per the release accompanying the announcement, the new high-power laser has been tested against UAVs. But officials involved in the demonstration have indicated that the system is designed to work against rockets too. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Israel's new airborne laser is a critical step forward. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. Videos posted online show the laser system is deployed on a Cessna 208 Caravan behind a windowed panel on the left side of the aircraft's rear fuselage. The Cessna 208 Caravan is a utility aircraft produced by Cessna. While very little technical data regarding the system has been released, DDR&D's Head of Research and Development, Brigadier General Yaniv Rotem, stated that the system successfully intercepted drones at a range of more than 1 kilometer, or 0.62 miles. Israel's Defense Minister Benny Gantz said the demonstration of the new system is significant, both in terms of cost-effectiveness and defense capabilities, and will add a new layer of protection at greater ranges and in facing a variety of threats, securing the State of Israel while saving the costs of interception. Israel has been targeted by different kinds of projectiles like short-range rockets, artillery fire, mortars. In 2011, Israel began operating the Iron Dome officially, which is a kinetic solution and uses interceptor rockets to take down incoming threats. According to Israel, it had been used to intercept more than 1,500 targets with a greater than 90% success rate since it was deployed in 2011. Though the exact data regarding the success rate is often challenged by critics, its overall effectiveness is well accepted. In the recent conflict, Hamas had launched a massive onslaught with more than 4,300 rockets. It was designed to saturate the Iron Dome system. While Iron Dome seems to have held its own even this time, it has limitations. Each Tamir interceptor used by Iron Dome has a reported unit cost of $100,000 to $150,000, while the rockets flung by Hamas militants will be a fraction of this cost. Also, Iron Dome can run out of interceptors when faced with a large-scale offensive. Lasers have some very crucial advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, as traditional air defense systems can run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats and need to be reloaded amidst a raging battle. Lasers are silent and invisible, which makes them very much suitable for use in the urban landscape. They're also so much cheaper and could cost as low as $3.50 per interception. This is very cost-effective compared to conventional weapons. For example, Iron Dome cost $49,000 per interception. An FIM-92 Stinger short-range shoulder-fired surface-to-air missile has a price of $38,000, and a Patriot surface-to-air missile costs around $1 million each. Lasers do have their own issues. They're susceptible to weather conditions since they rely on optics in order to successfully hit the intended target. But significant progress has been made in a collaborative effort involving Israel's Defense Ministry, Israeli defense firms, Rafael Advanced Defense Systems, Elbit Systems, and members of their academic community. Reports indicate that a breakthrough in the Israeli effort came about 2.5 years ago. The Israeli team of scientists and engineers was able to create a technology to focus and stabilize the laser beams over distances and overcoming atmospheric disturbance. An airborne counter-drone system also will be less impacted by atmospheric distortion than its ground-based counterparts. Airborne laser systems offer advantages over ground-based laser systems due to the fact that they can be carried aboard aircraft and therefore can be rapidly moved between locations. Israel's current Prime Minister, Naftali Bennett, when he was the Defense Minister, had stated, "If we successfully attach the system to an aircraft, we could overcome the hurdle of unexpected weather. We could potentially intercept rocket fire right above the enemy's heads." While the U.S. Defense Secretary, Lloyd Austin, has confirmed that the Pentagon will restock Israel's Iron Dome system, amounting to around $1 billion, it's paramount that Israel finds a cost-effective solution. There's a need for a non-kinetic system that can complement the Iron Dome and reduce its load. The Israeli laser-based interception system appears to be suitable for this kind of role. A system like this could potentially be installed on multiple aerial assets and knock out incoming projectiles from vantage points. Apart from acting as a counter-rocket, artillery, and mortar solution, the system could be possibly used against drone swarms and hypersonic weapons going forward. The effort is testimony that Israeli forces are not sitting idle and working constantly to mitigate future threats. And this is what's keeping it a step ahead of its adversaries.